She presents a mystery.
Just don't add up.
A love story and a mother who'll stop at nothing to avenge her son's murder.
You gotta stop playing detective.
Barbara Mandrell, now The Wrong Girl, a special NBC Monday night movie.
Freeloaders. You can find your own way home from here.
No way. You're not driving us back to school?
No!
How rude. Yeah, that's pretty damn inconsiderate, Fisher.
At this rate, we're hoping you don't come back to school next semester.
Yeah.
Still, when the pain of Monday morning from the pain of Sunday night.
Sneaking around like that.
I wasn't sneaking, and it's not my fault that that music you're playing is making you totally deaf. So I saw that the gang went back to school. How was your weekend?
Sorry, I can't hear you.
Very funny.
Yeah, we had a great time. A weekend at the lakes is just what I needed. And yes, before you ask, we left it exactly the way we found it.
Good.
Total mess.
I assume that the guys had a few beers. Did anyone get out of hand?
Mom.
I was just wondering if...
If I had a drink. No. I didn't. I know. I know the last couple of months have been really hard on everybody. Nobody expected what happened in school was gonna happen. I know. But you have to trust me. I have it under control, okay?
I hope so.
Excuse me. Hi.
Hey. Can I help you?
I'm looking for the manager.
In regards to, what?
I'd like to fill out an application. I'm Kelly.
Steve, hey. Manager's not here, but since I am the assistant manager, I could probably help you out. Since, can you finish this?
Sure. So does that mean you're in charge of hiring, Steve?
No, but I have some influence in that department.
Okay.
Okay. Come on, I'll get you an application.
Thanks.
Oh, God, yes. Sucker shot.
Okay. So basically, you tell me that this teacher's going... cut me some slack because she's you guys' friend.
Yeah.
Well, I wouldn't put it like that.
Look, I know that you guys are trying to help, and I appreciate it, but... it's just I'm not ready to go back to school yet.
and I don't know when I will be.
Come on, why do you want to go back to college? I mean, you don't have to pay for rent, you don't have to pay for meals, and you have a well-trained maid here at home.
Oh, yeah, you're one to talk, because you paid for so many meals of late.
Yeah, but I'm 14 and I'm supposed to be here.
Okay, I think we're getting a little off track here. Ruth Sherman is not trying to sign you up. She's just trying to show you the benefits of Braddock, that's all.
Right, other than the fact that it's 5 minutes down the road, so you guys can keep an eye on me.
Yeah, well, that too.
Stephen, please, just meet with her, okay? For me.
Okay.
You know, I don't mean to rush you, but I need to get back to work today. Now, is this what I need or not?
Hold on.
Excuse me, sweetheart. You do work here, right?
Look, maybe if you try shutting the hell. Well, you're in luck, sir. The man who knows everything about stoves is right here.
Hi. How you doing? Sorry about that. Can I help you, sir?
It's about time.
Thank you, sir.
Next time you get an obnoxious customer, just call a salesperson over, okay?
Can't I just punch him instead?
Yeah, just as long as they deserve it. No, just call me over.
Gladly.
All right.
Wow, somebody had a good day.
Huh?
Well, wait, what happened?
I don't know. Nothing. I don't know.
Hey. You're gonna like that. So, is the smoking section full?
Yeah, pretty much. But, for you, I'll make an exception. From Ohio, huh? How come you came all the way to upstate New York?
Because I knew every single person in Cuyahoga Falls, which isn't saying much. My aunt lives here, so I figured why not. You know what? We are pathetic. We should both stop smoking these stupid cancer sticks.
Hey!
We'll quit together.
You know, one of these chicks pretty much gets whatever she wants, huh?
Depends on what it is we're talking about, I guess.
Okay. I had to make you a deal. I'll go along with you on this whole no smoking thing. If.
Okay, deal.
I didn't say the deal yet.
It doesn't matter. I figure I'm in a win-win situation either way.
So I guess we're going out after work?
Maybe. Try sticking your butt out more. Choke up a bit on the back.
You're talking to a former all-star? Okay, so maybe it's Little League.
I prefer old-fashioned wood.
Oh. Okay. Whoa! That's quite a hit. I had no idea you played.
There's a lot of things you don't know about me, Stephen Fisher. I think that's changing.
So when's he gonna get here?
Your guess is as good as mine. Hey.
Ooh, this looks good.
Get out of there. I don't fly your plane and you don't mess with my kitchen, remember?
Yes, ma'am.
It still doesn't look right. So, am I late?
Hey, Bridget.
Hey, Bridgie.
Don't call me that.
Oh, you love it.
No, I don't. Welcome home, baby.
You look fantastic.
Thanks.
Pop.
How are you?
Good to be home. Hey, buddy.
Hey. That was the year you made state soccer, right?
No, that was 93. 94, I broke my leg skiing, remember?
Did you play soccer, Steve?
No.
Soccer was not my sport.
So, what is it you like to do, Kelly?
Well, I went to cosmetology school right after graduation, but I didn't really care for it. So, now I guess I'm not really sure. Sometimes I wish it was still okay to want to stay home and raise a family.
It is.
Not everyone needs a career, Kelly.
I'm going to remember you said that.
Well, I was just asking what she might be interested in.
Well, we do know she's interested in little Stevie here. $20 to anybody who can tell me why?
Do you work, Mrs. Fisher?
Yes. I'm a real estate agent.
She's been doing it for like 20 years.
Really? What do you like best about it?
Oh, the best thing is finding the perfect fit. Family, house, budget.
Mom says that she finds everybody's true home.
Cool. How great to know that even if your mom wasn't always around, at least she was out doing something worthwhile. I had a great time.
You did? They didn't scare you off? Mom can be a little much sometimes.
Nah, I think it's great your family's so close. Something I've always dreamed of, a big close family.
What's your family like?
Well, my dad dumped my mom for another woman when I was little.
That's harsh. What about your mom?
She tried, but she was always miserable. When I finally started getting to know her, she got cancer. She died last year.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. Life, you know?
Kelly, I like you. A lot.
Good, because I like you too. Who's that girl over there with Steve?
Oh, that's Missy Roberts. They used to go out. She's part of that whole crowd that hangs out at the lake every summer.
Excuse me. Can I buy this?
I'll be right with you. They went out? For how long?
Maybe 4 years. It started as a high school thing, and then again after he went off to college.
4 years? When did they break up?
Well, not too long ago. They're still really good friends.
What a great place. I can't believe you grew up with all this.
There's a lot of things you don't know about me, Kelly Garner. You ready to go sailing?
I have a better idea.
One step. Come on, we're almost there. Come on.
Okay.
Ta-da.
Aww. This is amazing. What's it for?
Our 2-week anniversary.
Aww. Aww. I don't know about that.
What, wrong brand?
No, it's just been trying to take a break from drinking. You know, I told you last year that I dropped out of school and all that?
Yeah?
There's a little more to it than that. I've been drinking a lot and screwing up pretty royally. And I got fed up and I split for a couple weeks. I didn't call anybody.
Oh, my family must have flipped out.
Yeah, pretty much. And, anyway, I just been trying to take a break from the booze.
But you're not an alcoholic.
No, I just a little scared.
Good. Then we can enjoy this. One sip won't throw you off the wagon, right?
Here's to our first 2 weeks together, and from now on.
To us.
You. I just can't.
Mom, I'm 21 years old. Are you telling me I can't go stay out all night?
Do you even know how busy Ruth Sherman is? And when she finally fits you into her schedule, you just blow it off.
Aha, the meeting. I'm sorry, I totally forgot. Kelly and I were at the lake and we got carried away. You think she'll give me another chance?
I don't know. Stephen, honey, I know you're happy, but please don't let everything else just slide.
I know. I know. I know, I'm sorry. I'll set up another appointment with Dr. Sherman, okay? Okay? The garden looks pretty.
I don't want to leave you.
Figure something out. There's no way that I'm losing you. In fact, I got a great idea.
What? I don't know what to say.
Mom, it's just for a little while. It's a couple of weeks. Till she gets on her feet. Come on, her aunt's moving. She's got nowhere else to go. Not everybody has a perfect family to fall back on, you know? Dad, come on, what do you think?
Well, there is that little room above the garage. She fixed that up.
This is all moving so fast.
Yeah, Kelly, could you excuse us for just one moment, please? Listen to me.
I'm not hearing what your mother's saying. Don't take this the wrong way, but we barely know that girl. And you barely know her. And to move in here?
Wait, I do know her. She's my girlfriend. Guys, I am finally happy. Don't take that away from me.
You look great up there, Steve. Two more loads.
Oh, good.
Hi. How's the move going?
Hi, Mrs. Fisher. It's going great. Hey, Bridgie.
I thought you hated that name.
No, I don't care. Hey, you guys need any help?
No, it's okay, honey. We got it.
Kelly? What are you doing in my room?
My mom never had stuff like this. Your things are so beautiful.
Yes, and they are my things.
Well, of course they are. Thank you so much, Mrs. Fisher, for letting me be a member of your family. Thank you.
About you.
I went shopping with Kelly.
And you took my credit card without even asking.
But you said I could.
With me. I never said you could leave this house with my credit card.
It's my fault, Mrs. Fisher. I should have checked with you first.
Never mind. It's over and done with.
Well, do you want to see what I got? Okay. This.
You've paid this much for ripped and faded shorts? I could have done this for free. Bridget, please go to your room.
Mom, this is so unfair. Just because you're jealous, I went with Kelly.
Oh, I am not jealous.
Why do you have to ruin everything, Mom?
sorry if I caused any trouble, Mrs. Fisher. I didn't mean to.
Kelly, I know that your intentions were harmless. But in the future, check with me before you take Bridget out with you. Understand?
I can't imagine my mother being nasty to you for no reason.
Well, she was. I mean, all I did was take Bridget shopping. I was helping, and now she hates me.
She doesn't hate you. She hates feeling usurped.
Well, I wasn't trying to usurp her, whatever that means.
It means to take...
You know what? I don't care what it means, okay? I love living here. It's like being part of a real family. How can I get her to like me?
She does like you. Everybody likes you. You just maybe gotta give her a little more time.
We've been married 23 years.
Thumbs up.
I was in the bathroom, Mom.
You never know what's going to happen at the Golden Globes, January 24th on NBC.
She did. Went to her house and said if she didn't stop going after Billy, she was going to get hurt.
No.
I don't blame her. If some chick went after Steve, I'd go ballistic.
You would?
Oopsie.
You would, really?
I keep forgetting we don't smoke anymore.
Yeah.
Excellent. These are what Richard calls mind erasers. I got you one, too.
That's good.
Are you ready to go home yet?
Yes.
Steven. Hey, what's up?
Missy. Hey, how you doing?
Well, I see your ride on the wagon is really rolling right along.
Hi, I'm Kelly, Steve's girlfriend. You don't have to worry about him anymore. I'm taking care of him just fine.
So I see.
Sorry. Yeah, Missy?
Kelly? Kelly? Missy?
Charm. Too bad we were just leaving, right, hon?
Yeah, I'll call you in a couple days?
Sure. Take care of yourself, Steven.
Jim, I think they've been drinking. Okay. I thought we could trust him.
Okay, you have your revenge. Upstairs?
No, downstairs.
Upstairs!
They're both going up to Kelly's. I don't like that one bit.
Honey, come on. He's 21 years old. He's a big boy.
Oh, I see. Boys will be boys. Drinking, sneaking around. I'm speaking to Steven.
Ash, look, if you get in the middle of this, you're just going to make him angry at you. Is that what you want?
Huh? Hey, morning.
Hello, Steven. Late night?
Yeah. Sorry, I hope we didn't wake you guys.
Well, I might have heard something, but I'm sure that you'll keep it down next time. Steven, please, a glass. When are you getting ready for church?
I'm not going to go today. Mom beat.
And whose fault is that? The whole family's going.
Mom, okay, I'll go to church if you make a big Sunday dinner. One of Grandma's recipes.
Okay, I'll think about it. Now go get ready for church.
Hello.
Chicken a la King, barbecue chicken, chicken Florentine, chicken gumbo, tandoori chicken, Nana Fisher's chicken sabatini.
He's just trying to help. It's nice, guys. Nice. Better go talk to her.
Honey! Honey, wait up! Hey.
She didn't mean it.
Well, that's, this place up.
Does this mean we're gonna go out for dinner?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Drive safe.
I'm hungry. Please give me something to eat.
Yes? But you have to be quiet.
Right. Wouldn't want to wake up the warden.
Mom, what are you still doing up? You're not so all wound up because of, like, the mess Kelly left in the kitchen, are you?
Stephen, honey, I'm worried that you're slipping back into trouble. And Kelly is not helping.
You blame her for everything. I'm totally sick of it. You know, all she does is she tries to blend in and she tries to be one of the family, and you can't handle that, so you knock her down every chance you get.
I do not keep knocking her down. Yes, I'll admit. I'm uncomfortable with Kelly living here. And I'm uncomfortable with your relationship. Your father and I think that it's time that Kelly moved out, Stephen.
You don't even care that she makes me happy, do you?
Yes, I do care. But not at your expense. And not at the expense of this entire family.
Good. And we understand each other.
Stephen, please don't be angry.
Too late, Mom.
Hello? Anybody home?
Hey, Mom.
I'm looking for your brother.
He moved out.
What?
Yeah, in the garage with Kelly.
DC's new mayor promising some big changes at 11.
allowed in?
Oh, of course you are, Kelly. What's up?
I just want to apologize for yesterday. I'm sorry about the food processor. I'll replace it.
Don't worry about it.
And I'm sorry about what's happening between you and Steve. I feel terrible that he's decided to move out of the house.
Yes, we do too.
See, that's why I have this plan, to get you guys back together.
I really don't think that
you... Wait. I've got it all figured out. See, if I can just listen to both of you and get the whole story, then I can...
I've known Stephen a lot longer than you have, all right? So just let it go. I think I can manage my relationship with my son.
I don't want to manage it, just kind of mediate.
Kelly, what part of no don't you understand?
Just wait. You'll see. I know I can help. Really, I can.
Steven, can we talk?
Kind of busy, Ma.
No problem. Go ahead, Steve. I'll take care of it. Huh?
Okay.
I just wanted to apologize for being so overprotective lately. Believe it or not, I do realize that you can make your own decisions.
Thank you. I hope you actually mean that.
I do. So, what are your plans now?
Plans?
Yes, are you and Kelly gonna get a place of your own?
I don't know. As long as I'm with her, I don't care. Mom, don't start.
What?
I can practically see you biting your tongue. It's kind of obvious that you hate her.
I don't hate Kelly. But the way you two drink when you're together, it scares me.
I can handle it.
You couldn't handle it before, son. What makes you think you can handle it now?
I can handle it, Mom.
If Kelly loved you, she wouldn't let you drink.
It's not Kelly's responsibility!
No, it isn't. It's yours.
Gotta go back to work.
Stephen!
Smear 10 tons of makeup on your face and he's still not going to come back to you.
Who? What, you mean Steven? I don't want Steven back, Kelly.
How cute! See, Steven just like Angela does.
Whatever.
You know what? They might buy your little Miss Perfect act, but not me, okay? I know what you're doing and it's not going to happen.
There you are. So, why do I feel like you've been avoiding me?
What are you talking about? Why would I do that?
You tell me.
Hey, why don't we go home? We can discuss this in bed.
No, I'm not going home yet.
Come on, Kel, it's like past 1 in the morning.
I said I don't want to go. What are you going to do, force me?
Look, calm down.
Don't tell me to calm down, okay? I'm not some little kid you can boss around.
Honey, why are you making me the enemy?
What? You want to go home so bad? Go, okay? Get the hell out of my face. I'll find my own way home. Go!
Hey,
kind of like, running around or I don't pay attention to you. Get off. What are you talking about?
What about stitches? Did they give you stitches?
No.
Concussion? Did they check for that?
Yeah, I got a slight concussion.
But otherwise, you're all right. Steve! What happened?
It's all right. It's nothing.
What do you mean it's nothing? What
it's
happened?
Okay.
Stephen? What's wrong? Oh, honey.
Mom, you're right.
Stephen, please don't do this.
It's just for a little while, Cal. I need some time to deal with my own stuff. I can't have what happened last year happen again.
So we'll stop drinking from this point on, I swear.
You're not listening to me. Last night, I was sitting in my truck, looking at the tree that I just slammed into, and I realized we're not healthy together.
It's messy, isn't it?
What?
You're still in love with her, aren't you?
What are you talking about? This has nothing to do with Missy.
You've been sleeping with her, haven't you?
Why are you being like this? You know I care about you.
Yeah. Not enough.
It's not true.
Stephen, please. Don't take away everything you've worked for. I know you love me. I know you do.
No. No.
Please.
We can't.
Yes, we can. Please. Steven?
Hey. It's been a long night, Mom.
You slept up there?
This has not been easy. Okay, what happened last night just happened.
What happened to making a clean break from Kelly?
Look, what is your problem? I thought you said you were going to let me handle this my way.
And your way is to hurt her even more by giving her false hope?
That's not what I'm doing.
That's exactly what you're doing.
I can't have this conversation with you right now.
Well, you're having it. You need to get yourself cleaned up and get back on the right track. And I'm sorry, but that means staying away from Kelly.
Don't tell me what to do.
We're not finished here.
Yes, we are. Yes, we are. Go find somebody else's life to run, Mom. Not mine. I've had it.
Stephen.
Mm.
Hope I'm not the person you're thinking about right now.
No, you're not. How'd you find me?
I knew you'd be here. Sometimes I think I know you better than you do. So when you're done, we can get going, right?
Going where?
To the lake. We have plans to go this weekend, remember?
Think that's a good idea?
Yeah. You're the one who said we need a fresh start, right? Chance to be friends?
I'm not gonna change your mind on this, am I?
Nope. Come on. You worry too much. Come on. It'll be fine.
Like I'm doing something weird here. We came here as friends, you remember?
So this is what you do, huh? Use people up and then throw them away?
What? Kelly, I just meant...
And then after you break their hearts, you sleep with them a few more times just for the fun of it.
Look, I said I was sorry about last night, okay? It was stupid for us to sleep together.
Stupid? Making love to me was stupid? You are such a bastard!
God, that's not what I'm talking about. I mean, I meant that it was a mistake. You know what? Whatever. It was a mistake for us to come out of here.
You know what? Just take me in. Now. Now!
I got a gorgeous sunset.
Go to hell. I really loved you, you know? More than anyone I've ever loved in my whole life. You know what? This is amazing. You really think you can end things the minute you feel like it.
You know what, Kel? Yeah. Yeah, that's right. That's exactly what I think. Because I can. Is that good? You feel better now? Is that what you wanted to hear?
Steven, I'm sorry, but I can't let you go.
You don't really have a choice in the matter, Kelly.
Steven, don't do this, please.
Stop! You all right? You okay? Are you okay? I'm sorry, I just...
Okay. I understand now.
Sure, you okay? You all right?
Yeah. What's wrong, Kelly? We were at the lake. He said he wanted to go for a walk alone. I waited for hours.
And?
I don't know. He's disappeared.
You look terrible.
Providence. NBC Friday, 8, 7 Central.
And what time did you and Stephen leave for the lake?
I guess around 4.
I see. And could you describe Stephen's mood when he got to the cottage?
Well, we've been having some problems, so there was that. And he was pretty upset over an argument he had with his mother this morning.
We did have an argument this morning.
Something about her yelling at him and how she didn't trust him.
And what was it that you didn't trust, Mrs. Fisher?
His drinking. I didn't think that he took it that hard.
Kelly, was Stephen drinking today?
No.
All right, go on.
Well, we decided to take the boat out so we could talk about stuff and...
Now, when you say stuff, what exactly do you mean?
Steve couldn't do what his parents wanted him to do.
And what was that?
To break up with me.
I see. When did you sail back in?
I guess around 7. Stephen said he wanted to go for a walk and think, so he tied the boat up and left.
I started to get nervous when he wasn't back in an hour or so, and about 9 o'clock, I really started to worry.
And that's when you drove back home?
Yes, to see if he was there, but he wasn't.
When will you start looking for him?
If he's not home by tomorrow afternoon, we'll notify search and rescue.
Tomorrow afternoon?
I have no choice, Mrs. Fisher. We're required to wait 24 hours.
Hey.
Hey. When'd you get in?
Late last night.
I'd have said hi, but Mom said you were already asleep.
Yeah, I crashed when we finally got back from the police station. I'm still exhausted.
Don't worry, okay? We'll find him.
I know, I just feel bad.
Why?
Steve and your mom.
There's some stuff between Mom and Steve that started when he was at school last year. It's not your fault.
I know, but still, I mean, did this ever happen to you? Did your mom ever dump on one of your girlfriends?
Well, no, but I know she can be a little overprotective sometimes.
I just feel terrible, you know? I mean, all I can think about is what I should have said so Stephen would be here right now.
Hey, you're not my brother's keeper. All right?
Jim, please hurry. Stephen might come back to the cottage, and I'd like to be there.
Ange, I know you're worried, but, you know, he's got a key. He knows how to use a phone. Stephen's a big boy. He can take care of himself.
You guys ready to go?
One would hope.
So look, I'll get these flyers made up. I'll meet you at the lake later.
That sounds fine, Kelly.
Okay. I have a good feeling about this. I think Stephen will be back any time now.
Is it okay if we set up headquarters inside?
Oh, please, whatever you need.
Hi, girl.
Hi. Any news?
Not yet. Search and rescue just started. How'd things go in town?
Plaster flyers everywhere. Hello, Missy.
Hello, Kelly.
So nice of you to come up and help the family.
Where else would I be?
4A through 4C have been cleared. By morning, we'll be back around this way.
Good. Then.
Careful, it's hot.
Thank you.
Did I make it right?
Yeah, it looks perfect. But then again, you know, seeing as how you made it, I'm not surprised.
Right, there you go. If you need anything else, let me know. But in the meantime, please get back to work. Thank you.
Call the rest of the college crowd?
Yep.
No one's seen him?
I finished his high school friends. There's no sign there either.
Okay, then. At least we have a better idea of where Stephen isn't.
I don't get it. I mean, the last time Steve went missing, he had a plan, you know? He packed a bag. He knew where he was going.
Mom?
Hey! Where have you guys been?
Searching. Kelly's relentless. I don't think there's one inch of these woods she didn't drag me through.
I didn't hear you complaining.
But you didn't see any?
No. I didn't find anything. Don't worry, Mom. I'll be back soon.
We haven't found him yet. I think you need to hear this straight out.
We haven't found Steve. In fact, we haven't found anything. All we do know is that he's not in these woods.
I'm afraid we're going to have to call off the search.
What?
But it's only been 4 days.
The police department is not giving up, Mrs. Fisher. Don't worry, we'll be keeping our eyes open.
Well, it's nice to know that you'll be keeping your eyes open. Call you in the morning.
Okay, sweetie. Love you.
I love you.
You back into town. I'm sorry.
Lord.
I'm really sorry.
No limits.
Pfizer. Life is our life's work.
Local ambulance crew gets lost on the way to an emergency at 11.
You realize this has turned into a murder investigation, right?
Yes, I know.
Therefore, it's important for you to go over every last detail in your mind.
Did he have a fight with someone at work, or maybe a new friend I've never met? Someone that could have followed you down to the lake? When we were sailing, I remember we noticed this weird guy in a speedboat.
Was he acting suspiciously?
Well, at the time, I didn't think anything of it, but looking back on it, he was just kind of hanging around.
Did he and Stephen talk?
No, he just sort of watched us a while, and then he took off.
Well, could you describe this guy or his boat to a police sketch artist?
Yes, I think so.
Excellent. Well, it's not much, but right now, it's the best lead we have. Thanks.
That was intense, huh?
Well, it just seems that he cares about Stephen's case.
You know, I hope what I said helped.
Kelly, I'm curious. Isn't that Stephen's St. Christopher's medal?
Yeah.
But how did you get it?
Stephen gave it to me.
A weird man in a boat? Why didn't she say something earlier?
That's what I was thinking. She's lying.
Oh, come on, Ange. Just because Kelly's a misfit or whatever doesn't make her a...
You can't say it, can you? That Kelly might be a murderer and her son is dead. But you think if you don't say it, it can't be true?
That's not fair.
She's wearing the St. Christopher's medal. Says he gave it to her.
Monday the 30th?
My father gave him that medal. He'd never give it to anybody.
Open casket. Yeah, I think if we schedule the funeral 3 days after the wake, it should give people plenty of time to grieve before he's buried. I don't understand.
Kelly, I can't say this any more clearly. It's not your responsibility to make our son's funeral arrangements.
You and Jim have been so devastated, I thought this would be helpful.
Yeah, well, I'm sure you meant well, but burying our son is a family matter.
Right, and this is how a family pulls together, right? Everyone pitches in. I'm sorry, Kelly, but you are not a member of this family.
It's not that we don't care for you, Kelly. We do, but...
Please. Stephen left me, okay? I can't be alone. I can't.
And everyone was just standing there, waiting, yelling for Steve to jump. But he was frozen in place. He was so terrified. So finally, Mom climbed up the tree, went onto the branch where he was sitting, whispered something into his ear. And the next thing you know, he's grabbing that rope and he's swinging out over the lake. And no one could stop him. At 6 years old, we knew Steve was the kind of person that wouldn't quit. I've always respected him for that.
Those are beautiful thoughts, Brian.
Thank you.
Thanks. He loved you so much, Angela. And he would be so hurt if you believed that all that could change because of one argument.
Why is everyone laughing like this is some sort of party?
Because this is a party. It's a celebration of Stephen's life.
Hi, guys.
Joe.
This is rough, huh? Yeah, it is. My family's taking care of me.
Meaning?
Not my family. Look, don't push me, Bridget.
Hey, guys, come on. This isn't the time.
Sorry. I'm sorry.
Angela home?
Sorry, they're out.
See you in a bit.
Okay. Angela. I'm so, so sorry.
I know, honey. I know.
Do they have any suspects?
Not really. Kelly says she saw some man in a boat out in the lake, but who knows?
You don't believe her?
I don't know. Things just don't add up.
I never trusted Kelly.
What do you mean?
You never saw them when they went out together, Angela. She knew drinking was his weakness, and I swear she used it to control him. And if you crossed her
or you got her mad when she was drunk. She...
What?
She could get violent, Angela.
Angela, telephone!
Okay. I should go. But we'll talk soon?
Definitely. Hello? Kelly, I thought someone was on the phone.
That's weird. Maybe they hung up.
I wondered if Kelly is being considered an official suspect.
Angela.
What? You want me to be quiet?
No. I just want to hear what they know about this, okay? You want to know my position here? I think Kelly's just a little girl. She's not a murderer. I mean, why would she do it?
It happens. But I'm curious, Mrs. Fisher, why do you think that we should be taking a look at Kelly?
Because I think there's a lot more to her story than she's saying.
Is this just a gut feeling?
It's a lot of things. Kelly's violent temper, her demeanor when Stephen went missing.
The medal.
She's wearing my son's medal, which I know that he would never have given her.
We can't haul people in based on hunches and circumstantial evidence. I need hard proof.
Well, then why aren't you out getting some?
We have, but we don't want to scare Kelly off. I'm sorry, I can't discuss this with you.
You're not the one whose son was found floating in Cherokee Lake, Detective. But if you're going to close your eyes to the possibility that Kelly Garner is involved in this, fine. But don't you expect me to do the same.
Mrs. Fisher? Mrs. Fisher, please don't do it.
She's very upset. I know you're doing everything you can. Thanks.
Make sure everyone in our family is happy.
Son.
No! No!
You got one for me?
Put your tray table up and prepare for
takeoff, my man!
All the taste, one calorie. Only one has it all.
Local ambulance crew gets lost on the way to an emergency at 11.
Okay, let's see here. Gordon. Ah, Garner. Here we go.
Cynthia, I can't thank you enough for this.
No problem. So, what did you want this for?
I'd like to get in touch with Kelly's Aunt Lindsay. Did you ever meet Kelly's aunt?
No. Come to think of it, I've never met any of her friends or relatives.
I know what you mean. Lindsay Ross, 209 Young.
So how come you moved upstate New York?
My aunt lives here, so I figured why not.
Hello?
Hello, is Kelly Garner there?
No, lady, you gotta pay for him.
Because I knew every single person in Cuyahoga Falls.
Come on, her aunt's moving. She's got nowhere else to go. Not everybody has a perfect family to fall back on, you know?
Hello?
Hello, Kelly. How are you holding up today?
Hanging in there.
I'm worried that you don't have any family to talk to. Have you called any friends or your aunt, maybe?
My aunt?
Yeah, you know, the one that moved back to...
Ah, from Cuyahoga Falls, you know, Lindsay.
Exactly. Are you too close?
Not really. Why?
Well, I know that your mother passed away, and I was thinking that...
You know what? I'm beat. I'm gonna head up to my room, okay?
Okay.
Hey, Kelly. I didn't see you there.
Just watching you shoot. You're good.
Thanks. So, what's up?
Just wanted to see how you're doing.
I miss him.
So do I. Wishing we'd never gone to the lake that day.
Yeah, well, I wish a lot of things. Wish Mom wasn't so torn up about their argument. I wish I'd actually been here, you know?
You're eating yourself up with guilt, aren't you? Don't, okay? Guilt is a wasted emotion. Nothing ever comes of it. It's okay.
Not even an L, Ross? And that includes the greater Cuyahoga Falls area? What about Garner? None? Thank you.
What are you doing in here?
Just hanging out. We've got some great stuff, Bridge.
The name's Bridget. Kelly, when are you going to go home?
Home?
No, the place you lived before you came here.
Well, I am home, Bridget. You said that I can't really deal with being around people who didn't know Stephen. You know, you're like a sister to me. I wouldn't want to leave you.
I don't want a sister. I just want my brother back. Look, Kelly, I gotta get changed, okay?
Drake. I was looking for you.
Really? Why?
I was wondering if you're free for dinner tonight. I'm making lasagna.
Dinner? I'd love to. Thanks, Angela.
You actually went through her stuff?
Look, the important thing is her name is Kelly Drake.
Where have I been? I apologize, Ange. I've been so unfocused. You're right. I just didn't want to believe that he was murdered. Or that Kelly was involved. I'll stay if you want. We have to take this to Jacobs.
No, I can handle this.
Okay.
Drake?
Yeah.
Mr. Drake, my name is Angela Fisher.
Hey, if that's Nancy Peterson,
I'd like to know if I can...
Lady, I don't care who you are. What do you want?
Day in hell before I talk to her again.
I was wondering, do you have a daughter, sir, a Kelly Drake? Mr. Drake?
So what'd she do now?
Excuse me?
Whatever it is, don't even think about trying to hang it on me, okay? Kelly took off last year, and that is the last we've seen of her, which is just fine.
Wait, are you Kelly's mother?
Last I checked.
Maybe I have the wrong Drake. Is this Kelly?
Yeah.
Oh, Mrs. Drake, I don't know how to tell you this, but your daughter... I think she may have killed my son.
You seem like a nice lady. And I am sorry that you got mixed up with Kelly. But that is your problem.
Mrs. Drake, she's your daughter.
Not no more.
For strange behavior, violent temper, false name, fake aunt, everything.
Well, it's very interesting stuff. Thank you for bringing it down.
Well, how long until you can bring her in?
Well, Mrs. Fisher, we really do appreciate all this work, but, you know, you've got to stop playing detective. Kelly could be dangerous, or you could taint evidence without even knowing it.
This just came in from Albany, Lieutenant.
Well, speak of the devil.
What?
Seems that Kelly Drake's record is as clean as Kelly Garner's.
Well, just because she's good at covering up her tracks doesn't mean she's innocent.
Oh, thank you.
Anytime. What?
Sit down, Angela. The coroner's report notes that there was a rope mark around Stephen's ankle.
What does that mean?
It's possible that the body was weighted down, the knot slipped, and... he floated to the surface.
Detective Jacobs, you know as well as I do that Kelly did this. This woman lives in my house. She trusts me. Isn't that something you can use?
Digital Doubler XT, working for you.
Yes, I will Kelly, I will definitely meet you. Yes. Thank you.
What is it?
I'm not sure. Some man just called, but he wouldn't identify himself.
Well, what do you mean?
Well, he said that he read about Stephen's case in the newspaper and that he had some more information.
Really? What kind of information?
He wouldn't say, just that he'd seen something that day at the lake. I'm supposed to meet him at the cottage this afternoon. He may be a crackpot, but would you help me check it out?
Yeah, we should definitely check it out. I'll go get my stuff, okay?
I'm really glad we're doing this together.
You mean that?
Yeah. I think it's time we all pull together, you know, instead of splintering apart. We haven't been that close, but I feel like that's the past now.
We've been close. I mean, we've definitely had our problems, but that stuff happens in families, right?
What if you and me, what if we worked together to try to figure out who did this?
Like a team.
You got it. See, the rest of my family may be happy to let everything just fade into the past, but we won't give up, will we?
Of course not.
I lost my son, Kelly. I don't want to lose you, too. Supposed to meet him. I know, as long as we're here, why don't we look around and maybe we'll find something that everyone else missed.
You think?
Well, it beats wasting a trip to the lake. Okay, let's start from the beginning. You're out in the boat, and you decide it's time to come in. How come?
Well, what do you mean, how come?
Well, you know, was it that you were tired of sailing, or there wasn't any wind, or...
Oh,
Stephen was so upset from the fight we had. Was he taking it out on you?
Angela, I really don't see how this has anything to do with
Stephen. Listen, sweetie. If you and Stephen had a fight or something, I'd understand. I mean, people fight.
We did have an argument, but it was nothing huge.
So, you came back in because you weren't getting along. And Stephen moored the boat and left. What's wrong? Oh, I'm not sure. Nothing, maybe. It's just that Stephen was such an expert sailor, you know? And the first thing a sailor learns is how to tie off a boat. But this is just a plain old knot, like somebody who never sailed might tie. But if he did tie this, I don't know. I mean, it's okay. You know, sometimes things just happen. Accidents happen.
No, I mean, that's not what I meant. Okay, we did fight that day, but it wasn't his fault. I can't even say it.
I remember how upset Stephen was that day, how angry. He wasn't himself. Was he drunk? Is that why you're trying to protect him?
He was out of control.
I understand. Just tell me.
It happened right after we docked. Stephen was tying the boat up.
You know what, Kel? You're absolutely right. That's exactly what I think. And you know what?
Then when I reached down and he pushed me away hard, like he couldn't bear to be touched, I fell backwards, and the next thing I knew, he was just there, staring at me.
You're right. I'm sorry, honey. He's just pushing so hard.
I was so scared. I thought he was going to hurt me or else I wouldn't have pushed him back. I'm sorry. Oh, my God. Baby, wake up.
Wake up. Oh, my God. Wake up! Baby, wake up! Please wake up, Stephen, wake up! Stephen, wake up! To do, you know, I thought the only choice I had was to leave him here and go call for help. I thought maybe I could find a radio or something.
You were terrified.
I have wanted to tell you for so long, but I was afraid I'd lose you. I tried so hard to save him. Please don't blame me.
It's all gonna be okay now. When Stephen fell, was there any blood?
No.
Well, then, why did the police find tiny specks of Stephen's blood right here on the deck?
They did?
Yeah.
Right when we were heading out, I remember Stephen had cut his ankle on this metal thing right here. He said it wasn't anything serious, but it might have bled a little bit.
I see. You know, there are two paddles. Did you know that the police found a broken one from the lake that they retrieved that exactly matches this one? And they found minute samples of his blood and his hair in the splinters.
I just told you what happened, Angela. It was an accident.
Hey. It's okay. It's okay. Whatever happened, you and I are gonna face this together, Kel.
I never meant to hurt him, Angela. You have to believe me, but nothing I said was getting through that day. I had to make him hear me.
Thank you. But the part I hope you're happy.
No.
What is this?
No, Kelly.
You set me up. You mean this whole thing? You set me up.
Your love, Stephen.
Last week.
Photography, eh, son?
Hey, it's all new, too. Must-see TV Thursday.
Is this your first time in Providence?
No. I grew up here a long time ago.
Why are you always running away?
I can't stay, Johnny. I've got a job to get back to.
So where do you think Mom is?
In heaven, bumming a smoke.
I love you, Sid.
You're not a vascular surgeon.
I could give you a rundown of my surgical credentials, but she'll be dead by then.
That was a gutsy thing you did.
I just didn't think she was going to make it.
She wouldn't have without you.
I came to say goodbye, Dad.
Goodbye is all I ever get to say to you.
Are you going to close your eyes?
Yeah.
I don't want you to go.
Ask me to stay.
Please stay.
Sometimes you can go home again. Providence, NBC Friday, 8, 7 Central.
This week, all your favorite must-see TV shows are all new. That's right, all new, right here on NBC. One.